living it? Do I live in it? So astounding. Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste the sea. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. Instead I stop a clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'ma live with the death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'ma live, I'ma live with the death. Yeah.
Oh, delivered a song, it's eternally heard. I search for truth, and all I found was you, my God. I only ever get my own. Jesus, we're living for your name. We'll never be ashamed of you.
Why would I dwell upon the wrongs and certain days when all I gotta do is look to you? Yeah, all I gotta do is look to you.
You probably do a better job running the world than I do. I just thought I'd remind you, I've been trying to find you. It feel like Satan working overtime, time suit. They say if it doesn't kill you, that refines you. But I'm trying to live, and that's bigger than surviving. It's been a long night, it's been a long fight. So just remind me now, everything will be alright.
Let me hear if you guys are having a fun time so far. Yeah. Guys, see, up next, we have somebody special coming in. His name is Johnny. I want you to make as much possible noise as you can.
Let's give it up! We out here.
Hey, lift the youth. I got one question. Are y'all ready to turn up for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Hey, DJ, drop that.
Weapon formed against me, you gonna hear it.
Never, ever.
It ain't me, that's the show, it's God steering.
They trying to tell you that something y'all hear me.
Look, I got the spirit in me, it's God fearing.
No weapon formed against me,
is gonna hear me. It ain't me, it can show, it's God steering. I try to tell you Jesus up, but y'all hear it, ayy.
I'm really grateful for my God, cause he don't let me out of sight. 360 in the air, I'm living right, I'm taking flight like Christ elevating. I'm really dedicated. You can't shake me, I stand tall. God forbid I ever fall, but he gon' pick me up. My team gon' lift me up, don't need my pocket stuff. In heavenly places, my seat is reserved. Straight from the spirit, don't gotta rehearse. This ground really cursed, evil spirits, they lurk.
I got spirit on me, I'm God-fearing. No weapon formed against me is coming near me.
Light.
It ain't me in control, it's God steering. Been trying to tell Jesus something.
Hey, turn that up, turn it up.
No, we coming and we loving it. Me something come from nothing. Give him praise. We ain't got nothing. Come to serve. We ain't all straight. Plays in his face. You'll know his ways. Heals the blind. Removes the shades. He cleans his ways. He takes the shame.
We lift the banner in his blood. We gon' show hate. We gon' show love.
He's in his hands like a glove.
Spirit falling like a dove.
I gave it up. Now it's stuck. I'm fully blessed. This ain't no luck. You either lot or you shot him. You gon' turn. You get struck.
Me, I'm God fearing. No weapon formed against me is coming near me.
It ain't me in control, it's God's
spirit. Bitch, I can tell you
Jesus up, but y'all hear it, ayy.
Yeah, I don't need no part of it. You know you my starter kid. Call me by my name, really knew that I was built for this. Fully raised, I'm stepping in. Change my ways from wickedness. Read the word, I'm tapping in. Jesus can't pay all of it. Really going hard for him. Baby, bread, we stop it. Stay tough on the Bible, kid. Preach his word, I'm binding it. Lay his life so I can live. Walk by faith, no slighting it. G-O-D, I'll fight for this. Teach him love like Christ had did.
Spirit on me, I'm God-fearing. No weapon for the kids, me is coming near me. It ain't me in control, it's God's spirit.
been trying to tell y'all Jesus told me y'all him.
I would leave a demon roasted, oven toasted. Monkeypox is with the COVID, the flow is so sick. Holy Ghost said we got chosen, cause he was roasting. Freedom out the cage like the kid that's golden. Put the needle to the record, we gon' leave it broken. We know that he holy, put the death the only. Spirit control me, his presence control. We can cover in that water and cook it like Benihana.
I got the spirit on me, I'm God fearing. No weapon from against me is coming near me. Been trying to tell you Jesus told me y'all hear me. I got a spirit on me, I'm God fearing. No weapon formed against me is coming in me. It ain't me in control, it's God steering. Been trying to tell you Jesus told me y'all hear me.
Hey, let's give it up.
Shout out to God.
God bless. Hey, this is my people, Jaden, Josh, and Vision.
Thank you. Hey, I like this crowd. Y'all lit. Get lit for Jesus.
Hey, look, the music is cool and all, right? But there's something so much bigger within this music that we're singing up here, right? Like, it's not so much about the music. It's more about the message. Because with everything you do in the name of the Lord, it is to glorify him and give him glory, give him honor, and give him praise. I got another special guest. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I'm gonna bring my sis, Riel, up here. We about to do, y'all wanna worship the Lord in this place? Y'all wanna do a little singing?
What's up? Come on, lifted youth, give it up. Let's go.
All right. A little backstory to this song. My sis is blessed with the vocals. She does the singing. You know, I don't
praise
sing.
God.
I can sing with a little auto-tune, but you know what I'm saying? But this song is, it's the topic on it is like lust. And lust is not always something like what we may think. Like, because in life, we can lust after a career. We can lust after the wrong things. We can lust after material possessions. Out of a relationship, lusting is desiring something that is not necessarily in God's will, or you can put it above God. And in life, I feel like that happens to us a lot. So we kind of wrote this out of a place saying that we don't want to choose anything else, that we only want to choose God in all circumstances. So let's play that song. Looking. Turn the song up. Thank you, Jesus.
Take a step back and I'll just let you pursue. They can all have the world without you.
life, we'll always be faced with an option. Every single day of your life, you're going to have an option on what you want to choose. The Bible says, choose this day who you will serve. And maybe a lot of us in here have a relationship with God. Maybe we don't. But each and every day, we have an opportunity to say, Christ Jesus, I choose you. I choose to look like you. I choose to sound like you. I choose to speak on things that will glorify you. And even when I'm faced with opposition or a trying time in my family, in my life, at work, at school, I'm not going to retaliate the way the world wants me to, but I'm going to choose you. Even when there's a desire in front of me that may look greater than you, I'm going to choose you. And that's what we can do each and every day. And it gives God the glory, because as long as we're here on earth, our aim and our strive is to look more and more like Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I got one more song. Y'all want to hear one more song? Now, I ain't gonna lie. I was on TikTok. I'll be trying to just post and get off, because TikTok is trouble. I'm gonna let you know right now. Like, I really am not on that. So, I was on TikTok and I was scrolling, and I heard this beat, and I was like, man, this beat's hard. And I'm listening closely, I'm like, that ain't it. Like, a lot of the times we can like appeal and cling to things because of the beat and really what it's saying. Even like accidentally repost things because it sounds good, but in reality, we listen to it later and we're like, oh, I don't know if I should be posting that. Or even listening to things that we don't know if we should be listening to, because if it's not glorifying God, even if we're not saying it or doing it, if it's coming to our ears and we're allowing it, we're coming into agreement with it. I'm a strong, strong, strong believer in not listening or watching things that aren't beneficial to you spiritually, mentally, emotionally, period. Like, there's no question. I personally have a non-negotiable for certain movies, music, etc., because you are what you say, and whatever comes within you in your heart, that's what's going to really come out of your life every single day, you know? And we got to really be careful about those kind of things. So this was a beat that I liked so much that I was like, man, I got to do something with this, because this is like my type of beat. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to let y'all see if y'all know it or not. Play the track, DJ. Turn the song up.
Yeah.
Hey, look,
I like what he do with me. You would think he threw at me. The way that old man gone, he won't come back. Everything new to me. Put that on a white tee. Say nah, he don't like me. Come up with that cross and he get checked just like Nike. Open up that Bible, homie. You gon' need revival, homie. Forget all them feelings, bust that script and get inside it, homie. Hey, way it hit like 4-5. All that flesh, it gon' die. Listen to my God, you gon' look at him and say, oh my. Yahweh, you know my God, you gotta look past the flesh. See past the veil, why you gotta check? He president with no politic. Can't hit the mark, you off of it. Telling my dogs they need a vet. Looking at their eyes, they really sick. Run around town trying to get a check. I like what he do with me. You would think he threw at me. The way the old man gone, he won't come back. Everything new to me. Put that on a white tee. Saying nah, he don't like me. Come up with that cross and he get checked just like Nike. Gas on no brakes. Saying roach, we spray. He already beneath the feet. You gotta know where he stay. No weapon for prosper. I just can't lift pops up. Lion Judah, no roster. In the sauce like pasta. Baby, praise gonna give you life. Can't go wrong, cause he make you right. Keep you in shape, no herbal life. Stay from the sin, there's more to life. In this real with the real life like. I ain't really with the pill life type. Slide with him if you feel like life. Stay on the hill and you will shine bright.
I like what he do with me. You would think he threw at me. The way that old man gone, he won't come back. Everything new to me. Put that on a white tee. Saying up, he don't like me. Come up with that cross and he get checked. Just like Nike. Y'all heard that before? Nah, but I think it's really important. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like we can't be influenced by this world. We can't let it influence and change us. I believe as Christ followers, even at y'all age, listen up, I got something really important that I'm going to let y'all go. But even at y'all age, it's so important to take the opportunity to just sit there when no one is around you, when you're all alone at home, about to go to sleep, think about the meaning of life and know that the meaning of life is far greater than you can ever imagine. God made you on purpose for a purpose. It's no coincidence that we're only so far from the sun and we don't melt or we don't burn and that we just happen to be made up of a bunch of atoms and we can all live together and operate and there's weather and there's season and there's just life. You just wake up and there's life. And I want to let you know that God made you to worship him. And until you really get that, you won't find true meaning in life. The true meaning in life is to surrender to the cross of Calvary, where Christ Jesus died, was buried for 3 days. He lived a life that you needed to live, but you could never live. And he died a death that you deserved so that you can be reconnected with the Father. And all it is saying, yes, Jesus, I choose you in my life. I may not have it all worked out right now, but I know you'll work it out through me. Even though I stumble, even though I mess up, I always want to choose you. I always want to live for you. Because this world has a lot of imitation offerings. And I know personally, I used to be homeless, strung out on drugs, so far from God in my life. I literally never knew God until 5 years ago. He met me on my way to prison, and he changed my life. And at you guys' ages, I was making the dumbest mistakes of my life. So I stand here as a testimony to the cross that what God did for me, he can do for you. And it won't take what I went through. I wasted my teenage years. I'm not even going to lie. Completely. So if you guys could get it right and like what God did with me in 5 years, I can't even imagine what he can do with half of you guys. If you would say, look. If you would say yes today, it would bless you so tremendously in the future. And it takes surrendering. It takes daily repentance. And it takes the most important part, the word of God. Understanding that word is the main thing that will help you in life. Because I used to think, personally, I used to think, like, losers and stuff were, like, the people that went to school and got good grades and did good. But when I was locked up, because I did over a year in jail, when I was locked up, I realized I was the loser. And for such a long time, I looked at the right things as the wrong things. And it wasn't until Christ came into my life and transformed me that I could see value in doing the right things in his name. And you'll only do that with the Holy Spirit and with the word of God. So I'd encourage you guys today that if you haven't before, or even if you have, continue to say yes to Christ. Continue to choose him each and every day of your life. Because what he has for you, you'll never get on your own earthly strength. You'll only get it with the Spirit of the living God in his word. I love you guys. Can I pray over you guys really quick before I go? Look, let's all bow our heads. Father God, Lord, I thank you for the youth here today, Lord. You are such an intentional God, and you are an on-time God that you knew who was going to be here before the foundations of the world. Father God, I pray that you would prepare this atmosphere for your Spirit to move in the hearts and the minds represented here today, Lord, that there would be breakthrough, that there would be revelation of who you are in each and every person's life in this room, Father. Have your way. Let your will be done. And prepare our hearts to receive what you have for us today. I pray that over each and every individual here, that you would move through lives like never before. You are the same, but do something new tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. So before we start this song, I kind of want to give, I guess, a little, breakdown of my week. it's kind of crazy that when I'm about to sing, it's what I've been going through, kind of. So I know that we all started school, and I was like, yesterday, I was like, God, like, how am I going to balance my life out? I'm in junior year. I have to study for so many tests. I have to see what college is, what I want to do. And I was just feeling so overwhelmed. I was like, I didn't know what to do. And I realized, I was like, God, like, he opens doors. He opens roads that I can't see right now, but I'll see later. I'll be like, that makes sense. I should have trusted you. I should have done that, right? And so I just want to tell you guys tonight to not feel overwhelmed, but to be grateful that you guys know a God that will provide you the tools, the Holy Spirit. So I want to read a verse that I found here, Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and future. See, when we have God in our lives, there's a bright future. We have hope because God is our hope, Jesus. So when you sing this song, praise him. Lord, you are going to fight my battles because I'm beside you.
Oh, no point of reference. You spoke to the dark and fleshed out the wonder of light. And as you speak, 100 billion galaxies are born in the vapor of your breath, the planets form. If the stars were made to worship, so will I. I can see your heart and everything you've made. Every burning star, a signal fire of creation sings your praises, so will I. How great you are, Lord, so will I. God of your promise, you don't speak in vain, no syllable empty your voice. All nature and science follow the sound of your voice. Ooh, oh, and as you speak, oh yes, Lord, 100 billion creatures catch your breath, moving in pursuit of what you. To nature, so alive. I can see your heart and everything you say. Every painted sky, a canvas of your grace. Creation still obeys you, so to die. Thank you so much, Lord. And as you speak, 100 billion failures disappear. Where you lost lost your love so I could find it here. And if you left the grave behind you, so will I. I can see your heart and everything you've done. Every part designed in a work of art called love. And if you gladly show surrender, so will I. I can see your heart a billion different ways. Every precious one, a child you died to save. You gave me life to love me, so alive. Like you would again 100 billion times. No one else you could amount to your dreams like. The world you never leave someone behind. Like you would again 100 billion times. The one that you could amount to your desire. You're the one who never leaves the one behind. You're the one who never leaves the one behind. You're the one who never leaves the one behind. Nobody, Lord, you're the one who never leaves the one behind. You're the one who never leaves the one behind. You're the one who never leaves the one behind.
Going through, I know we're starting school, it could be stressful, but you may feel unsafe other places, but here is very safe because God sent his son down so we can worship him freely, and nothing can ever change that. Just remember that no matter what happens, God is always by your side, and we can just live freely with nothing to be worried about. And I just really want us, as we sing this next song, to really just raise your hands, do whatever you want, because there's nothing to be ashamed of.
So I'll stand with arms high and heart abandoned. The one who gave it all, and I'll stand, my soul, Lord, to you surrendered all I am is yours. So I'll stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one. Surrendered all I am is yours. of the one who gave it all. So I'll send my soul, Lord, to you surrendered all. I am is yours. So I'll stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one who gave it all. So I'll stand my soul, Lord, to you surrendered all. I am is yours, and all I am is yours, and all I am is song we could ever sing. Worthy.
again, everybody.
Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
In the Savior's love, I find joy beyond compare, and this peace covers all of me. When you breathe within, you turn winter into spring. Grace dissolves every fear in me. Your love brings me to my knees, my King forever. You are all my heart's desires until the end of time. My soul surrenders. In my vacant heart, Lord, you came and made a home. You bring light to the dark in me. When I lose my way, I am beckoning to grace. You alone are my everything. Your love brings me to my knees, my King forever. You are all my heart's desires until the end of time. My soul surrenders. All the earth sing of mercy never ending. I will worship with all that is within me. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, King of heaven, yours is the glory. All the earth sing of mercy never ending. I will worship with all that is within me. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, King of heaven, yours is the glory. Your love brings me to my knees, brings me to my knees, my King forever. heart sees ours until the end of time. My soul
Thank you for allowing us to be here on this wonderful night, especially school starting. Everything could be stressful. And you can have us be in a safe space where we can be stress-free and leave everything out to you. I pray that as Nick comes up to preach, that someone here, if anyone's struggling, that they could learn something or get closer with God. I pray that everyone can enjoy tonight and they can go home safe and knowing more and feeling happier. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Say this. What is up, Zoe Youth? Bro, if there's any one youth group, I'm going to say it on TV, if there's any one youth group that I almost love as much as my own, it definitely has to be Zoe, dude. I love you, Juan. Give some noise for Pastor Juan, who's in the house today. No, no, no. Give some noise for Pastor Juan, who's in the house today. Come on, man. Guys, I'm actually really excited. Not because today is you know, back to school bash. I love the hype. I love everything. But truthfully, I love the message I'm about to preach today. If you don't know who I am, my name is Nick. I'm the director of youth here at Lifted Church. And we've been going over this sermon series called Clean. And it's this sermon series on purity. It's this idea of just understanding what purity really looks like in a biblical aspect. A lot of people, they'll look at purity and be like, oh, it means that I keep myself physically pure until my husband comes around. But it's so much more than that. In fact, I would argue it has more to do with what God has done for us. See, the truth is that we can only be made clean through Jesus Christ, who died on the cross and gave us an opportunity to have a relationship with him. This whole sermon series is looking at the biblical definition of what purity is. And if you missed it, let me catch you up. Week one, we really just nailed down what the foundation was. Our foundation is really where our heart is. Where your heart is what you're most devoted to. And our hearts have to be devoted to Christ at all times. Week two, we did this really cool analogy, but it's really just understanding what holy boundaries are, right? Like there are holy boundaries that have been set by God. And the truth is they were set there not because he wants to limit us, but he wants to see us grow. He wants what's best for us. And what's ironic is that oftentimes we fail to honor what God wants for us, yet we still call out to his name when we're the most troubled. Week three, it was really about purity being void of pride. Like, the idea was like, just because you're a virgin, it doesn't mean you're pure. It was this idea of like, no matter what you truly think you are, like purity comes down to humility. It doesn't have pride. And today, we're going to continue on with this concept. It's really about creation. So if you have your Bibles, notebooks, and pens, I encourage you, take them out. It's going to be a quick sermon while I have your attention. But we're going to be in Romans 1. We're going to be in Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1. The sermon title for today is called Creators. Creators. Romans chapter 1, verse 20. I'm going to be reading the NLT version. It says this: For ever since the world was created, people have seen the earth and the sky. And through everything God made, they can clearly see his invisible qualities, his internal powers, his divine nature. So they have no excuse for not knowing God. See, yes, they knew God, but they wouldn't worship him as God or even give him thanks. And they began to think up foolish ideas and what God was like. As a result, their minds became dark and confused. Verse 22. See, they claiming to be wise, they understood, or they instead became utter fools. And instead of worshiping the glorious, ever-living God, they worshiped idols made to look like mere people, like birds, like animals, like reptiles. So God abandoned them to do whatever shameful things their hearts desired. And as a result, they became vile, degrading things with each other's bodies. They traded the truth about God for a lie. So they worshiped and served the things God created instead of the Creator himself, who is worthy of all praise, eternal praise. Amen. Let's pray real quick. Lord, I just thank you for just allowing me to be able to bring your word. And so, Lord, I pray that you speak through me, that this message hits home for whoever's watching, whether it's online, in person, doesn't matter what time they even watch it, Father. I pray that you speak to their hearts, that you soften their hearts, that this message can be one from you where it allows us to rethink what we're truly worshiping, Father. Lord, I thank you for everything that you do, and I pray that today that we continue to have fun, but that at the same time we just worship you with everything that we have. It's in your son's name I pray, Jesus Christ. Amen. All right, so some of you guys don't know this. I consider myself a creator, right? I consider myself somebody who loves to create things. In fact, I'm really good at Photoshop. I'm okay at photography. I enjoy doing creative things. How many of you guys can say that you guys are creators? Raise your hand. Creators. Where are my creators at? Armin, raise your hand, bro. Come on now. Where's my creatives at? What if I told you every person sitting here is a creator? What if I told you no matter what you think, you are in fact a creator? You just don't know what you're creating yet. The truth is that every person sitting here does create something. I remember this one time. I'm not going to date myself, but when Minecraft first came out, man, I was on that. It wasn't for Xbox. It wasn't for PS. It wasn't for anything except the computer. And I remember I got the amazing opportunity to beta test it. If you all know what beta testing it is, it means I played for hours upon hours upon hours for completely free, so that way I could tell you where the bugs were at. That's basically, that was my job for a summer. And I remember I loved Minecraft. Dude, I became obsessed with it. I remember I was in college, my first freshman year, and I remember like I didn't do anything. Please don't mimic what I did. I literally skipped all my classes just so I can be on Minecraft. In fact, I would go to Dade, and on my laptop, I'd be like, oh, nice. Nice. And I built all these massive temples, these beautiful things. In fact, I remember this one time, I built the pyramids, the three pyramids, right? Massive scale. However, you walk into it, it was dope. You had to find the treasure at the very end, okay? And the crazy thing was, is that back in the day, they didn't have creative mode. So you had to do this while playing like hard. And you had to survive, and if you died, there was no save button. Like, you died. The world was gone. Like, that was it. And I remember the very first time I'm playing, I'm like, oh, man, this is crazy. I just so happened to build all three pyramids. And when I built all three pyramids, I was so excited. They had traps. They made sure, like, if you walked in it, the sand would fall. It would crush you. You would die. And then I remember one time I got exploded by a creeper. If you all play Minecraft, you know that those things suck. And it killed me. And again, this was before they ever had the save button. And I was like, man, that sucks. I tried finding my world, but if you have ever played Minecraft, you know that it's an infinite land. It's an infinite void. And I remember being so upset. This is a true story. I remember being so upset. I grabbed my laptop, and I raged, and I like launched it across the room, and it shattered. And I was so upset. But then I was more upset because I shattered my laptop. Like, junk, dude, what the heck? Like, that was my laptop. But I was so mad, and I threw it because I'd spent so much time on it. I had invested so much of my time. I had invested so much of my love and my passion for Minecraft. Years later, I recognize how childish that is. But, like, I was so upset that I was willing to damage anything in front of me because of me being upset. I say this because what's interesting is that a lot of us are like this. We create relationships, we create friendships, we create art, we create music, we create math problems that nobody can solve. Like, we are creators. We have been made in God's image, and guess what? God is a what? A creator. Some of you guys, you write poems, you write lyrics. Like some of you guys create things. And what's crazy is that sometimes we become so like dead set on what we create that we start worshiping the creation. We start worshiping what we built with our hands. In that moment, I could tell you right now, man, I worshiped Minecraft. I know that sounds dumb as junk, but I did. I got so upset, I had to smash the entire laptop, and then I had to go out and buy another one to then do what? Download Minecraft again. And it's so dumb, but yet we do this every single day. Like, think about your rooms. You have created a space in your own room that is yours. How many of you guys are messy? Raise your hands. I'm messy. I'm so messy. All y'all messy people, you can find things when you search for it, right? You created your own mess, but you know where everything is. Like, you have your own unique space for everything. You guys have created your room. And what's interesting is that the moment your mom comes up and picks everything up, guess what? You guys get mad, right? You guys are like, man, I know I put my t-shirt there underneath my bed, under like five pairs of jeans. I know it was there. Mom, what'd you do with it? Like, we all create things at some point in time. And the moment somebody comes over to mess it up, we get upset. The moment somebody comes to ruin it, the moment we don't have our way with that creation, we get upset. We begin to idolize those things. We are, in fact, creators. Why do I say this? Let's turn back to Romans chapter 1, verse 20. It says this, "For ever since the world was created, people have seen the earth and sky. Through everything God made, they can clearly see his invisible qualities, his eternal powers, his divine nature. So there is no excuse about not knowing God." Before I even continue, I want to say this right now. There is no excuse for not knowing there's a God. If you've ever taken the moment to just reflect, to sit back, to look at the sunrise, to look at how a car operates, to look at how iron is made, to look at anything, how a child is born, God has given you what's called a general revelation. It means this: God has shown him, himself, and his love through what he has created. You do not come up to something and say, oh my gosh, that was just created. It just popped out of thin air. Even science can say that, right? Energy cannot be what? Created or destroyed. So before we even start, we have to understand that there is, in fact, a God. Just by looking and opening up your eyes, there has to be a higher being. So Paul, in writing Romans, he says this in verse 21. Yes, they knew God. Everybody knows God. But they wouldn't worship him or even give him thanks. And they began to think up foolish ideas of what God would look like or what God is. And as a result, their minds became dark and confused. Have you guys ever been in a place of darkness or confusion? Have you ever sat there? Like the other day, I was walking up. I got a new house. It is so dark at night. And when I turn off all the lights, I can't see anything. And I was walking upstairs, and like my wife was sleeping in the bed, and I'm trying to go to like the bathroom. My bed's right here. The door's right here. And as I'm walking, we just moved in, so there's boxes everywhere. And I tripped on one of the boxes, and I made a bunch of noise. And all my wife did was like, huh? And I was like, oh, thank God I didn't wake her up. But I hurt myself in the darkness. I couldn't see. Like, we all have gotten to a point where we are dark and confused. We cannot see. We don't understand. And what's more beautiful is that we don't even look to understand. A lot of us are comfortable in our darkness. A lot of us are okay with worshiping the creation, not the creator. A lot of us are looking at the world and saying, no, it's okay. I'd rather, okay, not go to God, who's made himself abundantly clear that he exists. And I'd rather just look towards everything else the world has for me. Verse 22 says this, claiming to be wise, they instead became utter fools. Every single one of us here thinks we're smart. Isn't that something? Every single person here thinks that they're wise. We all can look at one other person and be like, I'm smarter than you, even if it's a child. And scripture says that thinking they are wise, they became utter fools. And instead of worshiping the glorious, ever-living God, they worshiped idols made to look like mere people and birds and animals and reptiles. So God abandoned them to do whatever shameful things their hearts desired. And as a result, they did vile and degrading things with each other's bodies. They traded the truth about God for a lie. So they worshiped and served the things God created instead of the creator himself, who is worthy of eternal praise. See, the world's problem is that we will actively worship creation. The biggest problem is that we actively seek to look at the creation. Let me explain. How many of you guys covet, or how many of you guys are waiting and counting to the days that you're old enough to get married? You don't have to raise your hand. I'm so sorry. That was rhetorical. How many of you guys are coveting a boyfriend or a girlfriend? Like, you cannot wait until that happens. What about this? How many of you guys are counting to the day that you get that new PS5? It was out like a year ago, and you're looking at it like, man, I gotta have it. Right? How many of you guys look at shoes the same way, like, bro, those shoes have to be in my closet or else I don't even exist. We all look at creation, something that somebody else has created, and we worship it. It doesn't have to be a person. It could be a thing. Bro, what about crystals? There's this like new thing where everybody has a crystal on their necks and that you give it some like divine power. Yeah, this one clears my energy. Bro, what about like astrology? Yeah, my horoscope. Like, I'm a Libra. Like, one of the funniest things, I remember when I was going out to date, I remember, like, right before I met Nati, I was talking to this girl. This girl asked me, the very first question she asked me, she's like, hey, so what's your sign? And I was like, what do you mean? She's a Christian. What do you mean? She's like, yeah, what's your sign? I'm a Scorpio. And I was like, oh, I don't believe in signs. Oh, well, we can't work out. All right, then. We're definitely not going to work out. We covet the things that have been made by man, but not God himself. You know what's crazy to think about this? God has created every single piece of land, every single blade of grass, every animal and insect. He has created every atom in your body. He's created the paper that we threw out today. He's created everything in existence. And when we consistently have proof that God is real, we will neglect it time and time and time again because we covet things rather than the creation or the creator. We will sit there day in and day out and say, man, I want that cardigan so badly. Man, I need a monster. I need a coffee, man. I need a break from my, like, whatever it is. Some of y'all, you just got to school and you're like, man, I'm coveting right now a vacation. I cannot wait to go to Disney World. And it's like, what, it's day two, bro? Like, would you do sleep all day? But this is the truth. We look so much for experiences and for people, and we look at them so deathly that they become idols in our lives. We will put women, we will put money, we will put games in front of God every day. Some of you guys, I want to say this. If you guys don't believe you covet things, do me a favor. Give me your phone for a week. See what happens. Give me your phone for 3 days. Give me your phone for 2 days. Give me your phone for 24 hours. And see how many times you ask for it back. We covet creation and not the creator. We don't sit there and say, Lord, blessed are you because you have made everything. We don't sit there, I can't remember the last time my phone stopped working. I'm like, Lord, you created this phone. Help me out. But it's the truth. It's the truth, man. The truth about purity is that it has much more to do with us and lusting after things, after people. It has much more to do with the position of our heart. I hear so many of you guys today like, yo, the moment I turn 18, yo, I'm gonna get that paper. I'm gonna get that money. Like, I need to succeed in life. I need to be a millionaire. I need to buy a Benz. I need to buy, you know, whatever it is. Bro, there's stuff. The truth is, you won't take any of that with you in heaven. The truth is, the only thing that you'll take to heaven is your relationship with God. I'm not taking my phone with me. I'm not taking my iPad with me. I'm not taking Monster with me. I'm not taking anything. So why do I worship them? But like, we have all of these things for a limited amount of time. Whether that's 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, 60 years, 80 years, however long it is, we have them for a small amount. But in that small amount, we have a decision to make. We either come to God and worship him with everything that we have, or we collect everything we have and put up against God. As if money, cars, phones, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, if that's going to stop you from dying. It's not. It might stop you from getting to heaven, though. Real talk. The truth is that today, right now, you have this path of purity. You have this opportunity to worship the Creator. Why? Because he gave access. He gave you access to pray to him, to be with him, to build a relationship with him. If you don't believe me, turn with me real quick to Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4, it says this. But God, so rich in mercy, he loved us so much that even though we were dead because of our sin, we were dead because we decided to idolize everything else in this world above him. He gave us life that he raised Christ from the dead. It is only by God's grace that you can even be saved, that you have been saved. For he raised us from the dead along with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms because we are united with Jesus Christ. Verse 7, it says this, so God can point to us in all future ages as examples of the incredible wealth of his grace and his kindness towards us, as shown in all that he has done for us who are united with Jesus Christ. See, God saved you by his grace when you believed. And you can't take credit for this. It's a gift from God. Salvation is not a reward for the good things you have done, so none of us can boast about it. See, for God, for this is true. For we are God's masterpiece. And he created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do good things that he planned for us to do a long time ago. And the truth about creation is that God created you guys, and he has a plan for every one of you guys sitting here today. And whether that looks like joining full-time ministry, whether that looks like just having a relationship with him, whether that looks like going out and evangelizing or doing mission trips, whatever it might look like, God has created you for a purpose that I can't fulfill. That a purpose that any pastor could fulfill. He created you. He loves you so much. The Bible says that he knows exactly how many hairs you have on your head. That's crazy to me, bro. I don't know about you, but I don't even have enough patience to count how many hairs I have on my head. Let alone how much patience, how many, I don't, for my arm, that's crazy. But he loved you enough. He loved you enough that he sent his son to die on the cross for you. He loved you enough that no matter how many times you decided to worship idols, no matter how many times you put your girlfriend above God, or your girlfriend or your boyfriend above God, no matter how many times you put Chick-fil-A above God, no matter how many times you put anything, PS4, put whatever it is above. No matter how many times you did that, God still sat there and said, bro, I love you. I'm going to die on the cross for you. I'm going to give you an abundance of grace and mercy. I'm going to continue to forgive you. All you have to do is repent. Come towards me. Have a relationship with me. It's interesting. My Minecraft, it can't have a relationship with me. I really can't. None of my drawings, none of my art, none of my music, anything I have tried to create, none of it can have a personal relationship with me. And truthfully, honestly, even if it could, I don't think it would care about me as much as God does. And yet still today, here we are, and we sit there and we put everything before God. We will continue to go and do everything before we ever open up the Bible. We will watch Netflix before we pray about that situation. How many of you guys, please don't raise your hands, how many of you guys get into a massive fight and instead of resolving the issue, instead of praying to God about the issue, you go out, put your headphones on, grab your phone, and watch Netflix? How many times do you guys go and choose everything else the world has to offer? And then choose God afterwards. Mike said something a couple weeks ago. So good, bro. Pastor Mike, he was talking about how sometimes we treat God as he's the last person we pick on a team. Sometimes we're out there and we're choosing whatever sport you guys play in school, basketball team. And we're out there on the court and God's standing there and saying, man, I should be your first choice, but yet I'm your last. I'm your last pick. Man, today, if you're worshiping creation rather than the creator himself, I want to pray for you. In fact, I want to give you an opportunity to get right before the Lord. See, here's the truth. God, he sent his son to die for you. He sent his son because he wants a relationship with you. Not like the perfect relationship. A relationship where all you ever do, you pray. You're in his word. And he loves you like nobody on earth can. He's patient. He's kind. And he sits there and says, man, I want a relationship with you. I want to get to know you, not because I don't know how you are or what you're doing in life, because I want to give you the opportunity to know who I am too. You ever see how that's crazy? Like, it boggles my mind even to this day. The creator of every little thing that we see, the person who has made it all, loved me enough to want to know how my day was going. Not because he doesn't already, but because maybe he just wants me to vent towards him. Maybe he just wants me to go to him and praise and say, Lord, like, this is what happened to me today. Thank you. And that boggles my mind every time I think about it. And some of you guys here today, you've been so stuck in worshiping the creation, so stuck worshiping everything life has to offer you, money, women, men, sex, name it, drugs, name it, whatever it is that you deal with, video games. And you covet this and you hold it so close to your chest, but you are so unwilling to give anything over to God. Today I'm here to tell you, bro, it's time for you to start worshiping the Creator. Why am I going to worship a piece of paper when God was the first person who even made the piece of paper? Why am I going to worship money when God's the one who can give me, the only one who give me money itself or life in abundance? That would be like you worshiping my Minecraft game. That doesn't even make sense. If you're here today, bro, and you want a relationship with Jesus, if you're here today and you're like, man, I hear about this creator, but I don't know him, bro, I'm going to say a quick prayer. And this prayer, it doesn't save you. But your willingness, your wanting to be with God, to be right with God, that is what saves you. With all heads bowed, I'm going to say this prayer. If you're here and if you mean it, just repeat this after me. Dear Jesus, Lord, I am a sinner. I worship creation rather than you. So, Lord, today I ask for forgiveness. Lord, I am sorry. But from this day forward, you are my creator. You are my Lord. You are my Savior. Lord, I don't want to go and worship the things of this world. But I want to worship the being who created the world. So from this day forward, I will follow you to the best of my ability. come into my life and make me new. In your son's name, Jesus Christ, amen. Guys, I want to take this time real quick to truly just worship God with everything we have. And man, if you're here today and that prayer wasn't you, but maybe you are a Christian, maybe you're sitting there like, man, I worship the world rather than my own God, the one who did save me, the one who is there for me. I want you to get up and I want you to worship him with everything you have. I want you to sing your soul out. Man, I don't care if you can't sing. God doesn't care. Nobody cares. What matters is you worshiping God rather than creation itself. What matters is you going to God with a pure heart, clean hands, and saying, Lord, you are deserving of my praise. So that being said, guys, can we have one last worship song? Can we get up and worship with everything we have?
Thank you.
Today, if you need any prayer, if you made a decision, man, I want to encourage you to fill out the Connect card. QR code's up top. Before I do that, I want to pray over everybody here that's worshiping. Lord, I just want to pray that your will be done in this next generation, Father. Lord, there are so many kids here standing that are about to go into school, that are about to get tempted, that are about to start worshiping creation rather than who you are. And so I pray for resilience. I pray that you just stand strong with them. Though that no matter who they are, no matter what church they go to, no matter what they're doing, what school they're going to, that, Lord, that you put somebody in their life that they can get connected with. Lord, that you show them just how strong you are when we have faith in who you are. Lord, that in this new school year, Father, that we don't get distracted by what the school has or what sports they're pushing down our throat or whatever we're learning, Father. Lord, that we just focus on who you are this year. Lord, that the first thing that comes to our minds when we wake up and the last thing that comes to our minds before we fall asleep is how good you are. And that no matter what we do here today, Lord, I pray for everybody in this room that we could just worship you, we can honor you, we can give our entire lives and our hearts over to you. And Lord, if there's anybody here that's struggling, Father, if there's anybody here that's already in the midst of some spiritual warfare, if there's anybody here that feels down and out, Lord, I just pray that you give them peace, that you show them love, and that you give them joy beyond all understandings, Father. That they can come into a relationship with who you are, and they can be reminded about how just good you are. Lord, I thank you for everything you do. In your Son's name, Jesus Christ, amen. Guys, I'm gonna give a couple announcements, but if that's you today and you just need prayer, you just need somebody to do life with you, I wanna encourage you to fill out or scan that QR code. I just wanna pray with you. I just wanna connect with you. But I'm gonna say a couple of announcements just real quick. Number one, we still have food, an abundance of food, so please do me a favor. When you leave, don't leave without eating. Your boy can't eat that. I gotta watch after my figure. Please help me out. All right, that's number one. Number two, do me a solid. Do me a solid. Go ahead and just remember, if you're a part of Lifted Church, remember that next week, guess what? We're starting life groups. We're starting life groups at Fridays. Be here. It's going to be amazing. Me and my wife are leading one. And this is an open invitation to anybody here today. Tomorrow, also remember that we are doing LCN. What this is team building, it's networking. If you want to be a leader, if you feel called to ministry, if you just want to learn and grow amongst anybody, be here from 9 until 12. We're giving away free food, so hey, if you just want free breakfast, come through. I got you, right? It's going to be from 9:30 until 12. It's going to be amazing. That said, I think we have one more hype song. Can we get rowdy? Can we get rowdy? Do you know what rowdy is? Can we get hype? Can we get on live? Can we get excited? I want to get excited. Can we do that? All right, let's go.
Are you excited for one more song?
Giving me a new heart, a reality, living for the one who sent me.
never be the same. My heart forever changed. I know the old me is over and buried in the grave. I don't care what they say, God, I'll never be ashamed of His love that saved me. 180, the type that never If you know Him, then go ahead and call up your friend. 'Cause we out here on a Friday where we be.